And welcome to the Rebel Love Show. We are a once a week broadcast from Manchester, New Hampshire, where we are pro pots, pro gun, and pro coffee. You can find all of our content at rebelloveshow.com.
Meow. Sorry, I thought this was Flaming Freedom for a second.
That's actually from Freedom Fiends, baby doll. That is not a Flaming Freedom thing.
That's a Flaming Freedom.
Where do you think Derek J got from? Because he's a co-host of Flaming Freedom. That is a Freedom Fiends.
We don't rawr. We meow like sexy kittens. Anywho.
Anyways, we have the hosts of the super popular Anarchy After Dark here. Studio.
No, I feel
not
like
other than Cody O'Fuckin'Kana.
I love how I'm the host of Anarchy After Dark now. Otel is just a thing.
Oh yeah,
the past.
Yeah. You still have Otel. Apparently, that's still.
I mean, yeah, we were gonna get. To
or
that,
it's just an afterthought.
I feel like because you're on our show now, you are. This is the Rebel Love Crew show. The Rebel Love Crew 2.0.
Yeah. Welcome to the Rebel Love
We're
crew.
All here.
You're finally moved in. You're here. It's been like 2 years in the making.
And Renee's so excited about it.
I know.
It's so amazing that Cody's here.
It's Cody's face that makes her like so enthused.
Yeah.
Look at that face.
So literally, you come here.
How long have you been here, Cody? How long did you?
Oh, like 4 days now.
4 days?
I got here Friday.
Oh, wow.
It's Tuesday.
It feels like 2 years.
Who wants
already?
To do the math?
Okay. It just feels like forever for me that you've been here.
Well,
how's your first 4 days?
Good. I can't hear myself anymore.
Yeah, me either.
Did you just turn me down, Rob?
I turned down a little bit because you're peeking. That's why I turned down. I could hear the crash.
You want to turn my cans back up?
Oh, there you go. You're good.
Better?
Yeah, you're up. You're all the way up, dude.
The first 4 days, I feel like, determine like the rest of your life here in the Shire. Or the rest of your Shire life. Who knows how long that'll last.
Why would
well,
you say that, the first
that
couple
can
days
be, that can be good or bad. I mean, granted, I did get a job within the first 4 days.
Exactly.
But your I've also spent a lot of time being drunk on a couch.
That's true. He
so,
has.
You know.
I mean, that's true. But how often do you get to be drunk on a couch and still get shit done?
This is true.
So, I mean, I feel like as long as you're getting shit done.
I'm convinced I'll be a productive alcoholic when I'm here.
A productive
I can
alcoholic.
At least say that much.
That sounds like every free stater. Most free staters are, they're going to be productive alcoholics.
No, you've just been celebrating for 4 days straight.
That's what I tell myself, but when does the party end?
Monday morning.
The party never ends.
The party never ends, you're
the
right.
The honeymoon never ends. Just get used to doing a lot of
actually,
drugs and having fun.
You start work Monday morning, and that's when your vacation is going to, like, you're going to be like, okay, well, I'm going to miss those 4 days drunk on the couch. I was sitting there taking for granted.
I do. I got to take full advantage of my free time right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, you don't, like, I feel like a lot of people just, like, worry about, like, what the world, like, thinks of them, and they feel bad about relaxing because everyone has to be so goddamn ambitious all the goddamn time. But sometimes, like, ambition is gonna come, you know, you just have to put it in motion. But feel free to kick back and, like, take it in, get drunk as fuck. Not me, I don't like to drink. I think I'm giving up on drinking, guys.
Why?
It's been truly inspiring.
Is this in regards to Liberty Forum?
What happened at Liberty Forum?
I didn't tell you. At Liberty Forum.
Story time.
At Liberty Forum, I had to.
Cody missed Liberty Forum because he was in Florida and Renee did Anarchy After Dark with Vermin Supreme.
Yeah.
It was a Vermin Supreme
which
show.
I missed it. I made sure that audio was still safe. So I just diverted him from what happened at Liberty Forum
because I don't want you guys to know.
Good call. You shouldn't have done that, though. You don't teleprompt with your plays, babe. Because I was going to go full on about how I had to carry you through the elevator and through the hotel, through the parking lot, up to the house, up the stairs, to the bed. I'm glad I didn't have to go down that rabbit hole, that whole story.
So this is the reason why drinking is not.
No, you know how most people get drunk and then after they get really drunk, they say, oh, I'm never going to drink again.
Yep,
My thing is, I never really.
I said that this morning and here I am with rum.
Well, my thing is, I never really liked drinking because it doesn't take like a lot for me to get very, very drunk. And I really hate throwing up. And I
a cheap date.
Yeah, and I feel like I don't like not being in control of my body. That's the one thing I don't about like being drunk. It's like I feel like I'm not in control, like, and I feel sick just most of the time, and I don't feel like it's fun.
Yeah.
Especially when it doesn't take much for me to get to that point. But I feel like it's not like that for other people, but for me,
I can't decide if alcohol lowers my inhibitions and my inner asshole comes out, or
yeah, that's the other thing.
Or like I can't decide if that's the real me or if that's the alcohol like taking over.
That's the other thing.
I'd
people
say
are usually assholes.
Taking over.
Usually people are, you guys like were assholes last night when you're drunk. Like people get asshole-y.
We weren't that asshole.
Yeah, it's just like, you know, you'll like knock something over. Oops, that fell over. Who gives a fuck? Yeah, I'll fuck that girl right in the pussy. Like Cody at the Chinese restaurant. Like,
oh my God, you at the Chinese restaurant. Oh my
this
God.
This is like.
No, I know. Is that what I said, though? Is that specifically what I said?
You're like, I'd fuck that chick in a pussy.
I'd fuck her.
I'd fuck her
right now.
Fuck him.
Fuck that guy.
Fuck everybody.
Yeah, you fuck like every other word as loud as you could.
Yeah.
And I did catch somebody from the table next to us like turn and look at me.
They're like, who the fuck is this guy? But yeah, that, back to my point. That's why I'm never just like, I don't like that feeling. And even now, if you're saying like, you know, you feel like the alcohol takes over, I don't want a drug to take over me. With MDMA, it's like I'm a part of that experience. Like mushrooms too. Like I feel like alcohol, I'm not, and I don't like that, and I never really have. So for me, it's just like I have 2 seconds of fun and then vomit. So I'm just done.
You're done forever. Forever, ever, ever.
No,
never
I don't
drink
feel like not
ever
forever.
Again.
Okay, I'll probably drink wine when we play Cards Against Humanity.
You are a wine drinker. That's for
wine.
Sure.
I can do some wine.
I don't know. Last time you did a lot of wine, you ended up having to.
You did not word it that way. The last time you did a lot of wine.
Yeah.
Like she's shooting up lines. Yeah. Something.
Just hey, like Frenzia in a box.
I've seen this woman do a lot of different drugs. Okay.
Yeah, and I'm true. Like a and I'm like a champ. Never. What am I like?
You know what knocks her out? Drinking way too much wine at a Liberty conference. That's what overdoes it. And that's when like the shit gets real.
Yeah, no, right? I got really sick and like I didn't throw up, but I don't remember half the night. I remember going to see Renee at some point. I went to her room.
She comes
and
up
Ian
to my
there.
Hotel room and like literally I thought she was like checking in on me or something.
Wait,
like,
you had a hotel
sure.
room at the Radisson?
Well, no, I didn't, but I was spending a lot of time with Jazzy, so I was like with Ian at the hotel room a lot. And
by the way, Jazzy took the best selfie with Verm Supreme at
Liberty Farm. I just remember walking into Renee's room and seeing Ian and going, Ian.
Yeah, no, literally, she's like, come on, we're getting out of here. I'm like, hey, I had to take the dog out anyways. And
we walked the dog. That was nice. And then I found you again. And then I don't remember anything else.
He fucking carried you in here. Like, literally, he
No, this is just like a random, like, excursion. That I went on by myself.
When was this? When did you even do this?
You guys were dancing on the dance floor.
You left the dance floor to go see Renee?
Yeah.
I knew you were gone for a while. I wasn't paying attention.
Well, see, babe, that's how much you pay attention to me. But anyway, back to the moral
That'll
of my
happen.
Story.
That'll happen, though. You get too into the dancing and just like
it was
nothing
fun, man.
Around you.
A
you're
lot
paying
of people
attention
dance.
To.
And that I love DJ Hudson Webson.
Yeah.
I was
DJ
drunk
Hudson
as fuck Webson. At a really lame dance club. When I was in Orlando.
why do you say it's so lame?
Because it's called The Groove, all right? And they were playing shit you'd hear at a middle school dance. But I was drunk. I was with my sister, my cousin, and my sister's incredibly attractive friend that works
and
at
your
Hooters.
Sister is incredibly attractive if you're watching
so
this
I've
show.
Heard. So I've heard.
Cody's sister. Get it.
That's not creepy at all.
Which one is your sister?
The redhead.
The redhead.
Legs for
can
days.
We not?
We gotta go
no,
there.
Because you know, what's going to happen. I guarantee people in the chat room are going to be like tracking her down on Facebook now.
I'm doing it right now.
Hey, Cody's hot sister, guys.
All right, just don't post the link in the LRN chat.
Okay, we're going on break.
Don't throw it to them.
We're going on break. More Cody's sister jokes when we come back.
Jesus.
Currency is too important a thing. That was fun.
Something's wrong in like this area. Smile. Yeah, it's the teeth.
What's wrong?
She got really big teeth.
I feel like I do too.
She's got a nose thing going on.
Let me
find the.
It sounds better now.
I don't know what's more offensive, you two saying she's hot or Renee like picking out things wrong with her.
I find it offensive.
What? I don't know what's wrong with you, Renee. That girl is fucking hot. You're
no,
a hater.
From the side. She's just got some like, she's just got Cody's teeth. Whoa. She's got like
Wait.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hey, can you guys go ahead and just do a mic-by-mic audio check? It sounds like at least Anne and Cody. I'm not sure about Rob and Renee.
Yeah, I heard myself peek a few times.
Yeah, Anne and Cody have definitely been overmodulated during that segment. And when everyone's talking, it's like combining together and it's getting worse.
Okay. All right. All right, Anne, go ahead and talk, babe.
Check mic. 1, 2, 1, 2. We can dance.
Sounds okay now. Okay.
All right, Cody, go ahead and talk.
Check 1, 2. Checking 1, 2.
Fuck her right in the pussy.
I cannot hear myself.
Yeah, he sounds a little distant.
Am I muted?
Cody does.
Am I muted?
You're not muted.
I'm not hearing. It sounds like mostly room noise.
Yeah, it does sound like that.
Yeah, I can barely hear you.
Check 1, 2. Yeah, this doesn't sound good.
Try a different mic, Cody. Just curious.
Yeah, go to just talking to Renee's mic.
Check 1, 2. Yeah, I'm just being picked up by Renee's right now. Oh, here
there
I am.
You go.
There we go.
All right.
Well, it was there, and then you lost it.
What was going on with mine earlier? Did you have me turned down?
I was turning it down because you were. I was turning the gain down because you were peeking.
Yeah.
I heard a crackle in my headset, so I was putting it down. I guess I'm gonna try the compression a little bit on you.
Yeah, you can give it a try.
Okay, just keep talking.
It sounds better now.
Fuck her right in the pussy.
No, it peaked.
It's still overmodulated.
Yeah, it's definitely peaking out now.
All right. Go ahead again.
Checking 1, 2. Checking 1, 2. See, now it sounds kind of quiet in my headphones.
All right, go ahead.
Testing 1, 2. Test 1, 2.
A little better.
A little better.
I'm moving the fader down a little bit because I have the gain all the way up.
You have the gain all the way up.
Yeah, to pick you up.
Yeah, I've got a dynamic mic, so it eats up a lot of gain.
Yeah, we're using his mic from the mic that Cody's on right now is the one that's from his studio, Ian. So it's a different microphone. That's why it's kind of like the first launch using that.
Yeah,
microphone.
We got the
look at that body.
We got the Heil PR40.
Renee linked your sister's profile.
God damn it! Jesus.
It's the little things that'll give me any pleasure right now.
Oh, wait. I can put that up. Can I put that up in the video? You want me to do that?
No.
No, that's so creepy. That wasn't even the point of the story. No, she's 3 years younger than me.
Okay.
She bi?
She's getting married. So don't get any idea. Do you know how weird that would be? Get that right out of your goddamn brain.
It wouldn't be weird at all.
Get that right out of your brain.
Keeping it in the family.
Yeah, we'd invite her up here and we'd keep it in the family.
Oh, good Lord.
When everyone's talking, Rob, are you looking at the levels and seeing what they look like?
Yeah, I'm seeing it. It looks fine from my perspective.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fuck her right in the
So I don't know.
Cody's sister, that is.
And everybody looks about even when you're.
Everyone looks pretty even from my perspective on here, looking at it.
Checkity check.
Everyone's coming up near like 4.
Can you turn my headphones up again?
Yeah, I'll turn yours up.
All right. Well, here you go.
All right.
We've already accomplished so much, but we still need your help to show the world we can build a shining beacon of liberty. Stop making excuses and join us here in New Hampshire. Visit freestateproject.org.
What the fuck is wrong with my mouth? Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. This is your Rebel Mistress here. And I am here with the host of Anarchy After Dark, Cody O'Connor, and Renee Late.
And, Rob as well. I'm here too.
Oh, yeah, he's there too.
And by the way, go to, if you're listening on LRN.FM, if you go to rebelloveshow.com/live, you can watch the live in studio cam.
Skype
multiple cams.
Us.
And yes, please, Skype in. Welcome Cody O'Connor to the Shire. You can do so. Skype username Rebel Love Show.
Yes. So we were asking Cody about his first 4 days, but I want to get into Anarchy After Dark because I feel like if I don't say it now, then I'll forget about it. And this is very important. You guys need to change those gas.
Change those goddamn motherfucking bumpers. No. This is an invention. It needs to happen.
Nope.
And they need to change. Nope. And, but here's why.
I gotta agree.
Don't say no.
I think Cody just needs to fucking change them and not tell you just to change them.
You need to
work with Cody.
Ian won't do it. Ian already told me he won't do it. So you can all go fuck yourselves.
Ian won't say anything to get your pants off, okay?
I don't think that's quite how it works.
And the second thing is, he wanted to give the show to Cody, is what I heard. He was like, you should just make the show. And so if he suggested it, all I'm saying is, maybe we should all combine and do a show, but we would have to change the bumpers.
Maybe you guys can go fuck yourselves. I have very little control in my life. What little control I do have, which I didn't even have in the first place, was over those fucking music beds for my show. You can't take that from me. That's all I have. What the fuck are you talking about?
You still have to show.
Hear yourself think before you talk.
Listen, I have a solution. I have a solution. So there are like four breaks or something like that. I don't pay attention. I know. How about you just keep like one of those songs?
No. We're not doing half ska fucking.
Yeah. No. There'd be no ska.
I don't have to do ska. No, that works for Otal. I don't think it would work for Anarchy After Dark.
Anarchy After Dark needs to be smoother. It needs to be something new.
I would think something.
And you should change it to Monday nights.
I want dubstep.
Yeah, dubstep, bass nectar. I also see some really gritty rough guitar intro just by itself.
Makes me happy. So go fuck yourself.
But your show's not a happy show.
It's not called Happy
After Dark.
It's Anarchy After Dark where you guys rant.
Do you understand how happy the music beds make me? No, you don't. So fuck off.
Actually,
that has nothing to do with you.
We just don't care.
I'm not changing them.
What if we kept the hardcore part and then just did hardcore punk?
I'm not changing them. It's not
hardcore punk would fit for Anarchy After Dark.
It would.
It would really fit.
It's not happening. Sorry.
I want breakdowns.
Cody,
I want people two-stepping.
Cody.
I want mosh pits of listeners.
Yeah. Cody, why don't you change your gay ass bumpers, huh? Yours are way gayer.
They're not way gayer. But that's the theory.
Okay.
Why? You got a problem with Primus?
Cody's bumpers rock. I love the bumpers
Cody's
on
bumpers aren't
live.
Great, but
I have the best music taste.
Listen,
you may not. Well, maybe I don't know.
It's pretty goddamn good.
If we all became diverse.
If we all became
a powerhouse, since we're all doing shows at the same studio, and you change Otel to just simply be Anarchy After Dark, and then you do it Mondays and Fridays.
Can't do Mondays.
Yeah,
because you're gonna be working.
That's
now.
Right. You got
oh,
a new
yeah,
job.
You got a
can't
job.
Be that. You just can't have a back to back. Like you need to spread it out somehow. You can't.
Can I just say Rob has a picture of your sister open this game.
Oh, come on.
He's been looking at this whole time. You took it too far, baby.
Too far now? Is this too far?
I don't know.
I'm sorry. Renee shared it in the LRN chat, so the people in the LRN chat get to see how hot Cody O'Connor is.
And that wasn't even the point. That wasn't even the point of my story. That wasn't even the point of my story.
Well, who knew?
I was talking about how I was drunk as shit doing my one dance move, which is this rowing motion, which is about all I have.
I'd like to do a rowing motion.
And I was so drunk and out of it. Okay, settle down. The point is they were doing a song where everybody had a line dance that they were doing, and I just continued to keep doing this while everybody was like, they were doing all this weird shit, and then they turn around every couple beats, and then they turn it, they keep, I didn't give a fuck. People were running into me, I didn't move. And by the way, and everybody else had left the dance floor. That was the point I was getting to, is they had all left because they didn't know the dance, and I was still just, I might have been on ecstasy.
Well, that sounds horrible, man. I don't know.
It was great.
All I'm saying is,
I think that should be a potential.
You said she's engaged, right?
Yes.
Lucky man.
Off limits. Even if she wasn't off limits, man.
Why, man? We can get her up here.
Oh,
it's her
so
choice.
Cody does have boundaries on who you can and can't fuck. Interesting.
Yeah, I didn't know there were boundaries.
Yeah, Cody.
Are there age
there
limits as well?
What is this?
I'm being a passive-aggressive bitch, Cody. Do I really need to explain this to you?
I know exactly what she's talking about.
About what?
Are you two going to fight on
it? Yeah, you can fight on it. It'd be great radio.
Ian would love this shit.
Yeah, Anarchy After Dark may break apart on the Rebel Love Show while on LRN.
Actually,
It'll be another LRN gold nugget.
Actually, I just realized that I really hate this girl because she fucking wrecked my relationship, so I don't even want to talk about her. I just
we really shouldn't. We really shouldn't. We really shouldn't. No, we shouldn't.
Anywho, back to our powerhouse situation.
The only headline is get laid, so I'm happier.
I hope she stops breathing. Speaking of literally.
Speaking of getting laid, I wanted to ask you two about dating because you guys were talking about Tinder earlier.
Ew.
And since Cody just moved to the Shire, I think he should make a Tinder and just get on it, man. You got a job. You're going to be having a little dough rolling in. You can save a bit, take some bitches out, you know, show them a good time.
What's hot chick in Manchester wouldn't want to go out with a radio superstar like Cody fucking Connor?
And you just got the two best wingmans ever.
Fuck
yo.
Yeah. See, I got a crew I'm rolling with now.
Yeah, it's all about who you hang around.
I got a crew. I'm working in goddamn mother effing radio.
And there's four the dream. Of us again.
By the way, I've had women like masturbate to my voice alone.
Yeah, fat, ugly bitches, Cody. You can
I don't
do
care. I don't care. I don't care. I'm still using that as a plus.
I don't ruin this. I like how no matter how miserable I am, I can still manage to rip on Cody.
You have so much fun with it.
She just has so much anger.
I know.
No, it doesn't matter. It still counts. He has women masturbating to his voice, which is a count. Hey, it's a win. And he might start doing
Stephanie
audio
loves
books with
my
me.
Voice.
Yeah,
she always Stephanie, has so much nice. You think Stephanie masturbates to your voice?
So wait, I don't know.
I
that
doubt
would be
it.
Great to find
I hope
out.
She masturbates
Yo, she
to
could
my
call
voice.
In on Skype and tell us if she does
Stephanie
or doesn't.
Stephanie Murphy masturbates to my voice.
Well, she probably, yeah.
So this weekend, if anyone asked me, which no one did.
Oh, how was your weekend, baby doll? I heard you did something with the legendary Stephanie Murphy.
Anywho. So as a new voice actor, it was my 6-month anniversary, and I wanted to start a networking meetup because there's this whole like voice acting community. Who knew? There's a community for goddamn everything. The internet's a great place. So I decided, like, you know how they do Liberty on the Rocks in certain places and it's like everywhere and anyone can have their meetings. I wanted to do something like that for the voice actors, like in the region, because they're everywhere, like Europe, like all over the world, in this like Facebook book group. Well, I'll tell you more about it when we come back.
I hope it's juicy, babe.
It's about...
Creamy.
Is it creamy? Creamy? Is it creamy audio?
Creamy.
It might be.
Very creamy audio.
Is it moist?
Oh, had to go with that word.
Okay.
Jesus.
My bad.
Cody.
Gotta leave the headphones on.
Jesus Christ. Like we're doing fucking radio.
What do you think? I'm a professional or something?
I don't know. I think you're supposed to be one. Who the fuck knows?
You're at least pretending.
Nah.
I don't think is the chat even working?
I think so.
So,
I think just nobody has anything to say.
Apparently.
But that's never the case. And there's like 6 people watching.
No, I see Renee there. There you go.
Oh, okay. I refresh. Oh, it said I quit. Well, it's true. My son used to hate to read. Now he's holed up in the basement with these
spooky truth books all day and night. Says he never watches TV. You know that part when I was walking up the stairs and I said, you know, I have a perfect thing to talk about. I'm not going to say I forgot what the fuck that was. I didn't put
it. Was it about you asking if I had a nickname or something?
No.
Because you did ask that and I didn't get a chance to answer you. I have a bunch of nicknames. Which is good.
And we have a bunch of nicknames for you.
Which is good because, do you?
No.
If you come up with something better than Cody, I hate that fucking name.
What?
So.
Why do you hate Cody?
Because
it sucks.
Pussies.
It sucks.
What sucks about it?
Can we talk about this on air, please?
Yeah, let's talk about your name on air. Let's talk about why
it has no gender preference.
That's the
like
beauty
that.
Of it. No. You could be androgynous. You could be like female androgynous.
He can be female.
You can be male.
You can't.
These are your wingmen.
No,
these are your wingmen.
You can't
Cody.
Be androgynous because your sister's so hot. Like, you don't want to be the uglier sister.
That's true. You got a high bar to fill there.
These are the people who are going to try to get you laid, Cody.
Yep.
Cody, I've gotten you laid on multiple occasions. What has Renee ever done?
It's true.
And
the one who actually fucked me.
Every time Anne tries to play matchmaker, it ends badly.
Who told her to do that? Moi.
I'm just saying she's the one who actually did it.
Wait a minute. Actually, who brought the other bitch over? Not fucking Anne. Definitely me. Especially the night that he got laid. I'm literally the one who texted her and asked her to come over and be with me.
Not that bitch. I just meant you.
What? Oh, so you just have one. Okay, so I got Cody laid twice is what I'm hearing.
What? Twice?
What? Yeah, how does that add up?
Time.
Yeah, because I brought the bitch over that he fucked whatever, however many weeks ago, and I'm the bitch he fucked before that.
That doesn't mean you got him laid. I got him laid from your vagina.
Pretty sure it was my mouth on his dick, so when that was you
laying him, I got him laid. That will never be me.
I'm pretty sure I'm the one that got that to go through.
No, that's what you like
actually,
to believe.
No, that was Rob.
I sweet-talked both of them at the Alt Expo Lounge. I went up and talked to both of them and told them to go get this shit done. Go back.
That was after I had came up to Renee and said, Cody it was a great
reason to leave that stupid poly party at the very least.
I know.
Why have all the poly parties been horrible?
I know.
What the fuck was I going to find? What were we talking about?
I don't know. I'm just surfing 4chan.
Okay, where's the rum at?
Did you share this show on our page?
Rum?
Yeah. Earlier in the day I did.
Earlier in the day?
Yep.
I love my Rebel Mistress cover photo. Why is it just a picture of you and Cody? Because you guys are not the breadwinners in here.
Oh my god. There's not that many Cody pictures. So, like.
Oh,
you have a few.
And it was Anarchy After Dark. I was trying to promote Anarchy After Dark. 0309.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show here on LRN.FM and also on IPMNation. Go check them out too. So during the weekend,
I was finishing.
Oh, all right.
Okay.
Which one are we talking about? Are we talking about Cody's?
No, I was just finishing
sister?
What I was saying before. No, we'll come back to Cody's
really
sister. Anyway. I set up a voice actors meeting at the local Moose Cafe here in Manchester, which is fucking awesome, man. Go like them on Facebook.
Get the ice Vietnamese from there. Jesus Christ.
And to Cody. Cody wanted to come. He said he was interested, and why the hell not? You know, he's here. He's been to that coffee shop or whatever. And I had a great turnout. It was Stephanie Murphy. There was actually one of the co-contributors to Audacity, which was awesome. And so he was telling us about all his updates and how to work certain features. And then just another cool lady who actually had heard about the Free State Project. She's a local, but she had heard about it back when it first started. And then when she heard the move was triggered, she was like, I'm so excited, like, for you guys. Like, I want to be more involved. Like, I've been following this movement, and I'm so glad you guys have achieved your goal. Like, this is going to make New Hampshire a better place. Like, and I was like, what the fuck? Like,
I know, coming out of nowhere.
Yeah.
She added me on Facebook recently.
Yeah. And she was like, yeah, I definitely want to hang out and be more involved. And I was like, that's awesome. And who knew I could meet someone, you know, in the voice acting community that I could introduce, like, to the libertarian movement. More events and stuff, because she wasn't in any groups or anything. That was really fun. That was basically my weekend. My second book called Through the Looking Glass.
Now, when's that coming up, babe?
Actually, it's headed to Amazon now, so any day now it's going to be out. Just search The Rebel Mistress. I'm really excited about this book. It has my logo on the cover.
Why should someone go download this book?
Yeah, tell us why.
Yeah, tell us. Give us. Can we play an excerpt on air?
No.
Oh my God. We could. This isn't like I. You know.
It isn't. It isn't. It isn't. Well, it's a novel. It's not really all. It's not erotica.
The soundbite commercial.
Yeah, you could pay. We could play the retail.
Why go find her voice when she's right fucking here?
I know, babe.
Well, if you like audiobooks, you'll like this story about this girl who lives in Romania. If you like to read, then go find this book. or if you don't like to read and you want to listen to my voice, read it to you. Go find this book. I didn't write it. I just narrate it for it.
Okay.
Can we rip on Cody now?
Yeah, let's rip on Cody a little bit.
Oh, I see what you got up there.
So, Cody.
I see where this is going.
Well, during the break, Cody was bitching about his name, and I was like, yeah, because Cody's a pussy name. And he was like, "What?" And then the other two laughed. And then I pulled up George Carlin's little skit on guys named Todd. I'm getting really sick of guys named Todd. It's a goofy fucking name. Okay, hi, what's your name? Todd, I'm Todd. And this is Blake and Blair and Blaine and Brent. Where are all these goofy fucking boys' names coming from? Taylor, Tyler, Jordan, Flynn. These are not real names. You want to hear a real name? Eddie. Eddie's a real name. What happened to Eddie? He was here a minute ago. Jackie and Johnny and Tommy and Bill. Danny, Larry, Johnny and Phil. What happened? Todd. Todd happened. And Cody and Dylan and Cameron and Tucker. Hi, Tucker. I'm Todd. Hi, Todd. I'm Tucker. Fuck Tucker. Tucker sucks. And fuck Tucker's friend Kyle. That's another soft name for a boy. Kyle. Soft names, like Cody, make for soft people. I bet you 9 times out of 10, Nikki, Vinny, Tony, and Eddie would beat the shit out of Todd, Kyle, and Tucker, and Cody.
Wow.
You added my name at the end, by the way.
Thanks, George Carlin.
Yeah.
Oh, you added
So, Cody,
name.
Why do you dislike your name so much?
What would your other
soft
name
names
be?
Make for what? Soft people.
You can make a new Shire name.
I mean, yeah, you moved. What name? You were talking about aliases.
Rename yourself.
Prior to. What would you want to go by now? You're in the Shire. You know, I mean, besides Alaren, not really. You don't have a huge amount
can,
of like
can
people
Can we all
met.
Think of names for you first?
Oh, yeah. Let's
my,
do some
my,
okay, Renee,
my
no,
nickname.
Pause. Renee, what's your nickname for Cody? What is his new name be?
You have one?
Oh,
you gotta
I gotta think of one right now.
Yeah.
Go oh, for okay.
It. His superhero Shire.
His superhero Shire name?
What is
That's
it?
That's gonna be so hard.
Okay.
Jackass,
that's good.
What was it you called it? When you first came back from Florida, like 4 in the morning.
Jack's a handsome
you were like, get up, asshole.
So
I think that's what you would just call me.
I
it's
walked
just asshole.
In the house and just smacked him and was like, "Wake the fuck up, asshole!"
Jackass, asshole. What is that's that? Not- What are those initiated? What's like that abbreviated to? Jackass, asshole.
Jackass, asshole.
Sounds like a wild Pokemon. Right. The Jackass, asshole.
That's too long. Okay, Rob,
I don't know.
What's
I
your Cody?
I got nothing as a good
you,
Cody.
You
nickname.
Have no imagination.
I
get
don't.
Creative,
I don't.
Dickbag.
Be creative.
I know. Yeah.
Well, he could probably keep the name Cody. Well, see, he has
but
a
we've
great
already
radio
discussed
name.
That
Cody
is for
O'Connor
pussies.
Is a great name.
Yeah, but
for
you have to say the whole thing.
Cody, yeah.
You got to say the whole thing.
There's like 6 million other pussies out there named Cody O'Connor. Like,
there
exactly,
are?
Cody O'Connor. Google it. How many people
No,
are
if I Google Cody O'Connor, I'll come up to his IBDM, his internet database profile.
And yeah, read off some of the films that I've been in.
Let me find it. Let me find it here.
I've been in the moving pictures.
Is he in the sister fucking porn? Look, is that the kind of porn he's in?
Let's go find out. I'm at IMDb right now. I'm looking at Cody O'Connor on IMDb. And he's been in Sodomania, Slop Shots 1, Heartbeat, Money, 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 Sodomania 10, Revenge of the Pussy Suckers from Mars.
That sounds like Cody right there.
That was a fun
before
one.
Dying. Black Velvet 2, Brain Surgery, Chug-a-Lug Girls.
The Booby Guard. The Booby Guard.
From Whisper to a Scream.
Sexophrenia.
New Wave Hookers 3.
The Sex Connection.
Playing with Fire.
Tunnel of Lust.
Sexophrenia.
I Like Anal.
Battlestar Orgasmica. That's my favorite.
For
by
I love, I gotta love the sci-fi
did,
based
what
ones.
What you did in that was gold.
Mind blowing.
I mean,
right?
I've never seen someone take
guys,
something so much
watch,
up the ass, and you did it.
Can I ask you an ethical question? Like, do you watch porn if there's like mutant dicks? Like, if they're like it's like some kind of like say Cody's like this giant green person and he has like this giant green penis and he's like fucking do you watch that porn?
I've seen some weird shit in my day.
You know what a porn go ahead. What kind of weird shit do you like, Cody?
Me and my buddies in high school, we used to watch anime tentacle rape porn.
And that is disgusting.
It was funny.
I'm judging you, man. Did you jack off to that?
By the way, in the chat room, once again, can we shut the fuck up with this cuck word?
Yeah, Jesus it's Christ. Really, I'm so fucking tired of the cuck shit.
It's old. Yeah. It's overdone.
That's like two Shire years ago.
Easily. Mighty cucks. Oh, you guys are so funny.
Mighty cucks. That's
so funny.
Battle cuck.
No. That's good. Cucktails. Woo.
Ba-da-ba-da-boom.
Wait, but I think it's true. Some people like being cuckolded. Speaking of that, are you into that kind of porn? Okay, back to the green penises.
Okay.
What?
I will say this. No. This is a judgment-free zone, all right? I do enjoy the sci-fi-themed pornos from time to time. Not every day. Not every month.
Is there lightsaber play involved?
No, I like the Star Trek porn.
Really?
Star Trek porn, yeah.
So
what is that like? They just pretend to be Star Trek characters.
Yeah, when you're dressed as the actor's dressed as Kirk and he's having sex with some fucking alien.
So what is it that you like about it? That there's like a budget, that there's a theme, that there's characters, you know.
Like, is it like in depth?
No,
like
it's multiple things. I like that, and also just like the fact that it's like another species. I don't know. I just find that another alien.
Well,
like
wasn't
an alien
that the
species.
Best part of Mass Effect?
Yes, that was a great
hands
part of
down?
Mass Effect. Oh my!
Wait, man.
Always
down.
Fuck the alien versus that weird, that shitty conservative
Wait, does it
chick.
Show
right?
Their,
oh my
does
god!
Does it show their
when
penises?
When you're talking about Ashley, for anyone that played Mass Effect. Fuck Ashley. You get a chance to blow her up with a nuclear bomb, you fucking do it.
And you should.
That Trump supporting bitch.
Fuck her. Right in the pussy. It's my new tagline, everybody.
Why did you
seriously
move to the Shire?
That chick? I'm pretty sure her name was Ashley, right? Mass Effect 1.
Yep, it was.
Okay. Yeah. There's a lot of decisions in that game where I was like, you know what? Fuck, I can't. I gotta put the controller down and think about the decision I'm about to make. After going through that game, when I had the ability to leave her at the bomb that set it off, I forget why that did that, but there's a part in the game where you have to choose who you're going to send to do that. Yeah, go over to that nuclear bomb and die.
Yep.
Because I don't want you in the game anymore. Cuck Effect 3, choose anal, oral, or vaginal for the ending.
Okay.
Did you ever play Mass Effect 2 and 3?
I played 2. I started 3. I never finished it. Everybody told me the ending sucked, so I didn't even bother.
Mass Effect is kind of like life. It's more about the adventure than the ending. It's about living in
the
moment.
It's about
the
journey.
It's about the journey. Yeah. It's about the journey.
Life's a ride, man.
See, I'm not a gamer anymore, and I probably won't be ever again for a long period.
I like that murderous bear game.
But, Rob, if we could get Rock Band going again... Would that change things for you? Could you imagine how much fun that would be?
I never played that game before, but I don't like. I'm not good at instruments. I'm not that kind of smart. I'm more like book smart.
I wouldn't mind playing. The only problem is I tried to log it back into my old Xbox Live account.
Yep.
Which I had like $200 worth of DLC on, and music alone. I can't remember the password again. I got locked out. Forever gone.
Yeah, no, I had the same problem. I don't remember the password, so it's like I can't do any of the songs.
Yeah.
But dude, I fucking killed it on that game. Playing expert drums. Could fucking master Tom Sawyer.
I could never do that. I was not the drummer.
Rush is gay.
I know.
You know what else is gay? You.
Can you imagine?
Rush is so much better than happy hardcore in like every way possible.
No, I think you guys should not do either of those things.
I'm not saying I would change the beds to Rush.
Flaming Freedom has the best bumpers.
Yeah, I will say that. Flaming Freedom does have the best bumpers on A La Ren right now. They do.
What do they got?
I don't know.
Sandstorm by Darude?
No. They got
isn't that what they used to have?
They got Nicki. They got a big fat ass. And then we got the Bruno Mars. Uptown Funk, don't give it to you. And then we got some, what's that when they drop the beat real low?
I don't know. I forget, babe.
Someone wants a happy hardcore cover of Tom Sawyer.
Please don't.
There is a cover by, what's that band? Mindless Self-Indulgence.
No way, really?
Yeah.
That I could listen to.
Yeah, it's not bad. It's not bad if you guys want to pull it up. Not now, because we're coming back, but...
Yeah, come back in,
Babe, why aren't you playing anything on the break? You got so much content.
On the long break, I'm going to play some music. I know
you're
busy, but
you can spare that tenth of a... You should have played one of Cody's porns.
All right.
I'm totally all set with that.
You sure?
Renee doesn't watch porn. No. Or masturbate.
And by the way, I was going to say, most of my old friends used to call me Codwa.
Codwa?
Codwa.
Was that before or after Face Dance 2?
What? Oh, are you looking at the movie?
Or Tunnel of Lust.
You know, it was just such a blur during that time. You know, just a blur of dicks and cum.
Just dicks and cum everywhere.
Yeah, yeah.
Semen was on everything that year.
You're like 2001 Jody Sweden. LRN.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. So I got a theory. From now on, when we find a good parking spot, we usually say that's a Ron Jeremy spot because if Ron Jeremy were coming to this event, where would he park? I feel like from now on, we should say we got a Cody O'Connor lusty adventure spot.
You know, I wish he could have said nice. That when we were on Elm Street this past Friday when we were welcoming Cody O'Connor to
well,
the Shire.
I'm sorry. I forgot about his porno year. Was it a year?
His what?
His porno years. I forgot about his porno years.
Oh yeah, yeah. No,
how many years? Been... How many years were I active?
Oh my
You've
god!
Been doing it
you
since.
Were, you were active. Let me go back. This
been,
goes back into the early 90s.
Early 90s, huh?
92
wait,
all the
wait
way.
Wait a minute.
How old were you in 92?
92. I was 2 years old.
I don't know if a Free State Project's ready for you.
Oh,
Cody
I'm gonna get so kicked out of the movement. Yeah.
I mean,
I was 2 years old and.
I will say that I do not believe a 2-year-old can consent.
Neither do I. I believe it starts between that and 16.
Look, I feel like as simple as this.
There's a few.
Gross
sayings.
If you're old enough to ask for it, you're probably too old to have it.
What?
Oh, if you're not old enough to ask for it, you're not old enough to have it.
So if you're old enough to ask for it, you're old enough to get it.
What do you guys think about if there's grass on the play ball?
No, I thought if there's no grass on the field, she's too young to chill.
Yeah.
I guess so. I guess
so. Yeah.
But if there's grass on the field, play ball.
So let's give the little backstory to what we're really referencing to. If for those that pay attention to, you know, the Free Stater community and all that shit, now earlier, last week, week ago, something like that, New Hampshire State House Rep Kyle Tasker was arrested by the New Hampshire State Police. Now, Tasker is not a Free Stater, but he's well known within the porcupine community. Was trying to hook up with a 14-year-old girl. The 14-year-old girl
online.
Somehow they met or met. I don't know if they met before.
No, they did. They never met.
They never met. Okay. She deleted them. And the mom somehow found out, called the police. They re-added him on her Facebook, and they were in control at that point. And some other human being on the other side of the internet
should
from
we get the
Kyle Tasker.
The article here?
Yeah, I probably should bring it up. Kyle Tasker to meet, and that's where they arrested him. They further raided his home, found drugs. It doesn't look good for him because the girl was 14 years old. He's now out on
bail, right?
Yeah, he's out on bail. I
kind of makes you wonder, considering he was going to get 60 years.
Yeah,
right?
And it was a $250,000 bail, I believe. It was $250,000, wasn't it?
What?
I think it was. Maybe
It was pretty high.
It was a high bail. Suffice to say, I wouldn't step foot near that guy at this point.
I just wonder how he got out like so quickly.
Find a new way to buy drugs, everybody.
Yeah.
I mean, because the first thing they did to Rich Paul when they took him in was like ask him to wear a wire, is what I've heard.
Oh yeah, so, I would not be next to him because I'd be afraid he'd be like somehow incriminating like as a part of his quote unquote bail or whatnot.
But let's get something straight. Cal Tasker isn't even part of the Free State.
He's not Free Stater
so
at all.
I feel like that is like the common misconception, and they're trying to bring like it down with him. Like their actions towards it, like I don't know. Like there's been a lot of arguing, but these are just individuals, you know?
So if he's not the Free State Project, why is everybody going crazy in the Porcupines?
Because
he is a libertarian
state rep.
Yeah, he's a libertarian state rep. He goes to a lot of Porcupine events.
Yeah, I don't know if he's a friend, but basically he's just a libertarian state rep, and he's done a lot of legislation on marijuana and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So that's like mostly what he's known for. So you know, same ideals kind of collide.
Wouldn't it be easier to ignore the problem until it goes away? I usually handle with shit.
Normally, I would say, I would imagine so, but
I feel like it's people's response to it. So, for instance, like, Rob made a comment on Facebook that I feel like really it all took off from there.
Look, I don't know what the issue is, all right? And I'm probably going to get a lot of heat, too, for this, but if there's no victim, there's no crime.
Yeah.
I don't believe in pre-crime. I'm not defending Kyle Tasker's choices.
Are you going to read what you actually like?
I said that he was arrested for victimless crimes. Talking to someone on the internet and being in possession of drugs, this, to me, is there is no victim in either one of those situations. Someone doesn't need to, you know.
Yeah.
We're in a situation where taxpayer money, money that's stolen from all of us sitting in this room in the state of New Hampshire, that's stolen from us, is being used to keep another human being in a cage for talking on the internet mm-hmm. and in possession of drugs.
And you have to wonder, like, does age of consent even come into play if they didn't have sex at all anyways?
No, the fuck it doesn't. No victim, no crime. Fuck these assholes in the Porcupines group. Like, oh my god, thought crimes are a thing now. Good, they did call the police because predatory behavior and blah, 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 blah.
I have no... When a libertarian goes status, they go status hardcore.
Like, yeah, it's like, you know...
It's sad to see sometimes.
I can understand if you don't like the idea of a year old fucking a 14-year-old.
I understand that, but to the
level of, like, I would cut his dick off. Like, whoa! Like,
yeah.
So much for peace.
There's a big difference between I don't support something to I'm gonna cut his dick off.
Also, like, I just feel like... I mean, I feel like I just feel like you can't make someone a victim. Like, you can't say because someone's, like, 14, they can't say they don't want to have sex. Because, like, I feel like there's such a double standard. If you're going to tell women they're in control of their bodies and they get to choose to consent, but, like, that's essentially telling them they can't consent at all. Like,
yep.
Because, if you're a certain age, you can't consent. So, that doesn't make sense.
So, is there an age, where it becomes not at all?
No. Don't even finish what you're saying, because it gets real weird
when you're talking about, like...
I personally have...
10, 11, 12, 13.
I personally have a rule of thumb in who I sleep with, all right? They cannot be old enough to be my parents, and they cannot be young enough to be my kids.
Yeah, that's, theoretically, that's pretty much.
I have like a 10-year gap, forward and back.
I would not.
Personally,
I would not go younger than 17.
I'm more.
I'm just saying personally.
No, I'm more of that way too, and I do understand where Renee's coming from. I don't think it has everything to do with age. It has everything to do with maturity.
True.
And I think people are individuals, so it just depends. Like every 14-year-old is not the same. Like, every 16-year-old is not the same. Every 30-year-old is not a fucking adult. Because let's take a look at this right here. Kyle Tasker may be 30, but I don't feel like his mentality was that of a 30-year-old. I really don't. Especially, you're a state rep talking to a 14-year-old on the internet, like, leaving trails, like, you're going to meet her, you're offering her drugs, like, you're not, like, being responsible or smart, like in any way, like knowing your status. Like, so I feel like he isn't really that mature. I can see why he'd want to talk to a 14-year-old
That's the big gray zone.
Because he's probably in her maturity level.
Yeah, like, you so can't it would make
say
sense
that
for
someone's
him.
An like it works both ways. You can't say that someone's an adult because of an arbitrary number. You can't say that someone's a kid because of an arbitrary number. Like,
well, the fact of the matter is he's in a cage cell right now, and he didn't harm a single person. Like, period. Yeah. End of discussion. Like,
you don't even have to like him. Nobody's making you like him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No one's saying he's not stupid.
But it is wrong that he's in jail.
Yeah, I don't think, like, in that situation, the cops should have been called, because at 14, I feel like she made the right decision and stopped talking to him.
She was
talking to him. She stopped talking to him. She deleted him off Facebook. Like, the cops who, like, re-empted this.
If Kyle Tasker had continued trying to communicate with her
even though she was deleted
after the fact, then maybe I would agree to some extent. Like, okay, now he's literally trying to like showed up at, like, you know, her school or work or something like that, or home, like, you know, like that's when you get into stalking, harassment,
which would be wrong for any.
He's talking to a personality over the internet, and, like, the internet has no age. Like, if as long as you can type something, like, typing a sentence and sending it on a messenger does not, like, convey how old you are, you know?
Besides, on top of that,
people can present any personality.
You know, this is coming from the movement where we believe that no one owns their kids, that everyone's a free human being, and, like, you know, the whole unschooling and all that jazz, that kids can, you're pretty much there as your caretaker, but they're allowed to make whatever decision. This girl made the right decision. She stopped talking to him.
Yep.
But even if she wanted to,
there's no harm. Like,
even if she wanted to, I feel like it's still her decision, because when you're old enough to make decisions about your body, your decisions stand because you own yourself, not your parents, not the government.
I have a mini rant about this when we come back.
The Catholic Church can trust only the best with defending God's plan. Conclave 6 is the deadliest team of bishops I've ever laid eyes on.
The Pope denied rumors that a B-team of needle-wielding priests had been deployed to a latex factory in New Jersey to poke tiny holes into thousands of Durex condoms. Locally, the best part of a gay 12-year-old's day is the half hour he spends eating lunch alone in a stairwell. Calling it his only respite from constant ridicule and mockery, 7th grader Ben McElroy says life doesn't get better than the moments he spends quietly laying out his lunch on a secluded staircase while the rest of his classmates are in the cafeteria.
This is the Onion News Network.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. And when we went to break in the last hour, we were talking about the Kyle Tasker fiasco. For those of you who are just tuning in or whatever, I don't care. Kyle Tasker is a state rep from New Hampshire, a fairly liberty-minded one. He was arrested for trying to lure in a 14-year-old girl who he had been talking with over the internet, and they raided his house, found a bunch of drugs, blah, 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 blah. Yep, states, fuck them. I can't think straight or pretend to be happy. Sorry, guys. But anyways, one thing I wanted to do, because there's a bunch of porcupines up in arms over this.
It's causing, like, a fissure to happen. Yeah.
People are calling for ostracism. Every other status is like ostracize everybody.
Yeah, literally. I'm so pissed. But everyone's like, Kyle showed predatory behavior. And so I have some messages from Kyle Tasker here that I would like to share.
Are you really going to read off Kyle Tasker messages?
They exhibit predatory behavior. So Kyle messages me back in, like, August. Do you need a boyfriend? And I'm like,
Wait, were you over the age line? This might be incriminating evidence.
Yes, yes. And I was like, LOL, legit. And he's like, I like what I see, even if I don't know everything. I'm like, LOL, and you're dead ass serious. He's like, yeah, why? I'm like, I just had to know. You got balls, dude. I'm kind of seeing someone, though. He's like, oh, you're already involved? Sorry, that's why I asked. And I'm like, kudos for being straight up, but yeah. Wow, oh my God, the second I said I'm taken, he stopped. Wow, yeah. Such predator.
But even, like, yeah. He's just like, I don't don't know. He's just this guy, and like,
he's just a horny dude.
Yeah.
You know
yeah.
how many fucking guys I have messaging me like, I want to fuck you, blah 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 blah. Take your clothes off, and I'm like, stop, I'm taken. And they're like, oh, but who cares? Are you sure? Who,
yeah.
Blah 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 blah. Like, wow. Thanks, Kyle Tasker. I respect that you fucking stopped when I told you that I had a boyfriend. Like, thanks for not being a typical internet dick. Like, you were honest. You didn't act like, hey, I just want to be friends and, like, fuck with my head. You were just like, hey, need a boyfriend? No? Okay, bye.
I mean, I feel like, realistically, people are saying, like, the most ridiculous things. And you can tell they're not in our generation. They're... And even if they are, I don't know if they're, like, jaded, because they're fucking kidding me. Ever since MySpace was invented, which I was 14, I had a MySpace, and guys were hitting on me every single day that I didn't know. And guess what? I bet you they were all older than 14. It's no doubt. And ever since they've had MySpace, MySpace died, Facebook. If you have those things, people are going to try to talk to you, and it's your choice to talk to them back or not.
Right.
So it's in like at that point the age limit was like 14 to create a MySpace, I think. I don't even remember.
I think it still is for Facebook, but who actually follows that shit?
It's 13
for Facebook.
It's 13.
I believe.
Okay. So but my point is, I'm just saying, like, if someone is old enough to use that technology and pursue something, then they're old enough to make decisions for themselves. That should not be grounds to go to someone's house and raid them. Like,
yeah, no, this was like blatant entrapment. So this little bitch, and I am mad at this girl. I am mad because she chose to talk to this guy. She added him as a friend, blah, 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 blah. Now, I'm sure that she knows that it's like, you know, illegal, right?
Yeah.
So, well, not like talking to him is illegal, but I mean,
apparently it is.
Even becoming that much of a liability to somebody, you know? Like,
she let the situation happen.
Right. But then I will give her props, because when she did want to stop, she stopped. But apparently that wasn't good enough for her bitch fucking cunt mother. Fuck her. She was just trying to protect her children. You don't understand until you have kids. No,
fuck I don't agree.
You. Fuck you. Like,
talked to my daughter about her decision. Why call the cops?
Exactly.
Like, is your daughter not a human?
Because
that's what you're telling her. You're telling her, no matter if she says yes, if she says no, her body's not hers. Like, talk about fucking rape culture.
And that's a fucked up message.
State is you're implementing
and
it.
Also, can I just say that statutory rape is not a fucking thing? I don't care what anybody fucking thinks about any teenager ever. Age is arbitrary.
Yeah.
So, and let me tell you this.
It's
like,
rape.
People are saying that I was raped when I was with Ian at 16, who's like, I don't know, he was like 32 at the time, and I'm 16. And then all of a sudden, I'm a fucking rape victim. Like, excuse me? I've been actually violently raped. Do you know how insulting that is? Do you know how fucking insulting and infuriating that is? When I read those fucking comments, like, I literally feel like I'm red in the face.
Yeah.
I'm fucking
and
so
not only that, but for some of the people saying in those comments that at the age of 14, you're not mentally developed.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Sometimes
earlier,
people don't even get mentally developed.
You don't
though.
Have
that's
the mental.
Like, some people don't even mentally develop.
We're all in
physical age
mentally.
Does not play into emotional age. They're two different things.
They
are two very different things.
That 14-year-olds have a reduced mental capacity.
That's what I was thinking of. Yeah.
What the fuck? Like, where the fuck do you get off? You didn't know me at 14. I don't care about every other 14-year-old. Okay.
But
like,
they're just.
It depends
going
on every. Individual.
They're not even researching.
Dude,
it's the
society
thing. It's all back behind
them.
Ignorance. Like,
how ignorant really are these ignorant. People if they're collectivizing based on age?
But yeah,
based on every individual. There are 14-year-olds who are probably definitely not ready to be doing that stuff. There are some that are.
I definitely think I would like appreciate more if anything was backed up by some research, which isn't true, because if you do the research, like, 14-year-old girls are developed more. Like, there are studies. There were 2-year-olds hitting puberty at some point during the near future. Like, I mean, during now. Like, if you research it at all and look it up, like, the age that women reach maturity is getting younger
it
and
younger
and
younger.
I don't even care, like, what's
well, that's
out
because
there on
the of
internet.
The milk they're drinking.
I don't even care what's on the
internet.
It's
the milk, it's the meat, it's
the
whatever. But I'm. It's not the internet. I mean, like, research statistics, because people don't know shit and they're just like blindly saying these things. Like, women are like maturely ready to have babies at 16, and that's how old, like, back before politics played into play, everyone was married by 16. And
MTV have a TV show about getting pregnant at that age.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah,
they're like glamorizing.
So if they're putting that shit on TV, it's like,
yeah,
obviously that's going on.
My grandparents were married at 14 and 15 because that's how it was back
then. That's how it was in the South, yeah.
Yeah, and they had kids and they had a farm and whatever the fuck else. Like, I just find it like really bizarre that now that we're pushing that, oh, now someone's a victim if they're not this age. Like, I just find it like retarded.
Wait. What I don't get in this is the fact that, you know, again, there's no victim, there's no crime, and I can see, like, I don't even agree with Kyle Tasker going after, like, trying to hook up with a 14-year-old. I get it, he's horny, might find her attractive, whatnot. I personally wouldn't. I get why people are upset to a degree, but at the same time, no one was harmed at all in that situation, and who cares if he has drugs? Like, I don't care either about
that. Even when it did get really, it wasn't him talking to a 14-year-old girl. He was talking to a fucking cop.
Yeah.
So, and only, as far as I know, so far, only one half of the conversation has been released. They are purposefully making Kyle Tasker out to be a monster. That's what the media wants because that's what the state wants.
Well, I'd like to see those messages because I can't believe the police do this all the time.
The state does this all the time. There's situations, not exactly the same thing as Kyle Tasker, but there's moments where like the FBI will go to like, you know, people they think that might be extremists and try to get them to do something, but they're the ones instigating it to begin with.
Yeah.
You know, how is it this wouldn't have happened had the police not instigated him to do so to begin with?
Yeah, they never would have spoken to each other again.
I still believe that part of the reason that they are doing this is because they knew it would create an enormous rift in the liberty movement. I mean, think about it.
I know I'm going into conspiracy territory, but I think they just fell on a gold mine and now they may.
Look what it has done to the Liberty Movement.
I think this guy, like, obviously he's not, like, I'm sorry, he's not super intelligent. Like, if he really was talking to a cop for that long, he should have known something was suspicious. And second of all, I think they just knew he was a drug dealer. He's a state rep who's, like, slanging drugs.
Yeah, he's blatant about what he does.
Like,
it's clear entrapment. It's clear, blatant fucking entrapment.
Yep. They went after him for a reason, and he gave them every reason. Like, I'm not saying that he's smart. I'm not saying that he's right.
Moron.
I'm not saying, like, any of that. Only thing I'm saying is, like, you're taking, like, actual victims and putting, like, you're destroying it.
You're dehumanizing people. That's why I'm no longer a friend of the FSP. I fucking hate the media. I fucking hate the police. Fuck all those assholes.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by...
See, my big thing in, like, the fucking Facebook threads, besides, like, the crazy ostracization shit, and I kind of want to go talk about when we get back, is the fact that the ones, like, defending going to the cops.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah, you gotta leave it on, dude. I'm sorry.
I had to fix my shitty hair that I need to cut, sorry.
It's okay. Them defending using violence against Tasker, like, or advocating violence thereof. I'm like, what the fuck?
No, it's messed up, man.
And like, how people literally want to create, like, you know,
I don't know what's going on, like between this and the whole Edward Snowden recording bullshit. Like,
oh my god, that was
people need
such
to calm
bullshit.
The fuck down, because you go through these comments and half of these people are like, well, now I know who not to include in my social circle anymore. Now I know who to delete from my Facebook.
Wait.
Police. We are your premier polyamory hippie stoner and
I love
all around
okay.
fun.
Yes, I agree, dude. It's fucking bullshit. Like, people, how they're freaking out about. There's so many fucking threads. People going off on Garrett Ian because he didn't go along with the marching orders. Like, you shall not record video. A Liberty Forum.
It's like, dude.
And if you do, well, there'd be hell to pay.
People just need to settle the fuck down. We're not going to agree about everything, but this whole, like, I'm done with the whole thing. I'm done with all these people. Like, we're going to not agree on shit sometimes. Like, shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
We still all have the same goal. And for people to get so quickly to, like,
say this on
I cannot.
Yeah,
I'll save
come back
it.
To
but
this. We got to come back to this.
please share the link on your social media. And
hey, look, it's Renee.
That's not Renee.
No, I know. On radio, babe.
Is it a Trump and Hillary mix?
Yeah, it's Scared Ian's profile picture. I want to bring this up on the YouTube feed. So if you're watching on YouTube, this image came up of Garrett Ian. It's photoshopped. Oh, I gotta get it smaller. I gotta get up there. Hold on.
Oh, the one I sent you guys? Please be the one I sent you guys. Sorry, not sorry with the broccoli.
No.
Oh my god, no.
That was funny though. This is the one of him being in it. ISIS.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I've seen that one. Unbelievable.
You scare me.
What is this?
Garrett Ian. It's like this too, with his head about to be cut off. Because that's pretty much the mindset of what are you doing?
Right, it's like forget all of the good activism he's done, you know. One thing you disagree with and fuck this guy forever.
Right.
It's fucking it's so aggravating.
Feed in high quality 24/7, even when there's no live show being produced in our Keen studio. Wait, there's more. Our chat room is built into the cam page so you can interact with other listeners online. Listen, watch, and chat. All free at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government
Jesus
might
Christ.
Not like?
I have a show clock. I'm not even paying attention. I thought we have like another 30 seconds.
Protecting yourself against we come back at 20 past.
I know. Well, it's 19, so I looked at it. I'm like, shit, like, okay, I want to mute everyone for a second.
Cody, you can bring it back.
Yeah, Cody. Bring it back with your rant about porcupines. Make some enemies. You've only been here a week.
Yeah, let's do it. That's rats. 4 days in, let's fucking make some enemies, motherfucker.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air.
Ian's like,
area.
I did not say
it. Broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
All right, welcome back to the Rebel Love Show, which you hear every Tuesday night, 10 p.m. on LRN.fm. Skype is up. Skype is up at Rebel Love Show because this is a very controversial topic we're talking about right now.
Cody's sister's boobs.
That's the one, right?
Get her to move to the Shire, too. You're going to bring her with, right?
Oh, my God. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. You guys need to settle the fuck down.
It's so hard to, man. She's fucking hot.
Well,
anyways, controversy in the Shire.
We both have good genes. What can I say?
I get that.
Disagree. I don't even know how she's related to you.
What the fuck? Bitch.
Jesus, babe. That was a low blow.
I'm cutting you out of my social circle.
You're going to ostracize me,
I'm deleting you off Facebook as we speak.
She needs to be banned from every
ostracized.
Cody O'Connor event that happens in the future.
You are banned from my life.
Damn.
Don't even look at me ever again.
Okay, I won't look at you anymore.
No, but seriously, okay. Can we settle the fuck down on the internet?
I don't know, man.
Can we settle the fuck down? I was saying over the break, you know, the people going crazy over the Garrett Ian recording Edward Snowden's event at Liberty Forum and the Kyle Trasker thing and everything else is that, you know, we're not going to agree about everything all of the time.
Cody. At least we're not having a huge debate about fucking ice luches anymore.
Yeah, that's true.
So I do have an excerpt here from one of the assholes who was going off on the whole, like, ostracize all the people from one of the threads in
one
of the pork Facebook groups, blah, blah, blah. So, and I want you all to keep in mind that this is the husband of someone who's, like, really big into organizing Free State Project events. So, like, this is kind of a big deal to me because, like, this is, you know, like, inside shit here. We seem to have done a very poor job developing any systems for dealing with people who, A, actually do violate the rights of others, or, B, or are just plain antisocial jerks and set the movement back. Make it harder to implement liberty, make the community look bad, and everyone else, and so on. For the former, the main problems are usually, for any group of humans, theft, fraud, assault, sexual assault, the existing justice system will have to do. If we try to implement our own systems of enforcement now, the government will start arresting our people. So for the actual crimes, I still suggest that we do call the police until we are able to set up our own systems. I don't like the police being involved at all, but letting people get away with without real consequences for actual crimes such as theft, fraud, assault, and other sexual assaults is not acceptable and cannot be sustained. For the latter, we can deal with that now simply by ostracizing them from the movement. If those who are liabilities are rather than assets to the movement, my suggestion, if we want to succeed in creating liberty, is to start... blah, blah, I don't care. I'm done reading. It's not going well for me today. But basically, my deal is that, like, these whole, like, theft things or, like, property right violations are, like... Because they're calling... people are saying that their children are property, and if you make sexual advances at what they consider to be children, they'll threaten to cut your dick off, blah, blah, blah. Like, I don't know. Or the whole recording thing at Liberty Forum. I saw Dennis Goddard. I'll name him. I don't fucking care. He was like, I'd be the first to press charges if I'm in that camera shot, Garrettian. And I'm like, are you fucking shitting me, dude? Like, is this... How is using the, like, what? We don't want to use their money. We want to use Bitcoin. We don't want to validate their shit. But now here's this asshole. Like, we need to call the police until we can set up our own system. Like, dude, are you
the
fucking
fuck?
Kidding me?
The
advocating
fuck?
For calling police. And this is not the first. This post only has like 30 likes. But this other lady had a whole long post about how she takes such good care of her daughter and blah 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 blah. Such close bond. Blah blah blah. Much stuff. At the bottom of her post was like, yeah, I'd call the police if someone ever tried to pursue my daughter. And I'm like, are you fucking shitting me? Like, why we're anarchists and libertarians, why the fuck are we wanting to get the police involved in anything ever? Like, what the fuck is wrong with you? What is wrong with this group of people who I used to be proud of? Like, I know it's part of the movement just like growing, but like, Jesus fucking Christ, people are validating this shit.
Yeah.
What the fuck? And then the whole, let's ostracize anybody, because like those lines are so blurred. And
I think the point that we're overusing this is at this point.
Yeah. People are having power plays to the point where it's like, even there was a comment, I'm going to say Rob kicked out of, well, he didn't get kicked out of, he got vetoed from a particular social group. And it's all because a certain person didn't like him. Not his actions, not that he hurt anyone, not that he punched someone in the face or anything like that. Just simply because someone didn't like him. I don't know. Whatever. But the thing is, you have people commenting like, okay, you're agreeing to ostracize everyone, and I think this is why your system doesn't work, because you're ostracizing people for social vendettas. Like, who are actually, like, helping and promoting things and actually, bringing something into the community. This is something that someone else posted about this particular situation. So, like, this is one instance where, like, they're just, like, ostracizing on, like, power trips.
This is supposed to be, like, the love-olution, right? We're supposed to love everyone.
Right.
Am I wrong with that?
Thank you for bringing it in that fucking direction,
you
know, man. We need some level of
show for.
We need some level of emotional intelligence and honestly some kind of spirituality if this is going to be
successful. It's supposed to be a free society. No, you're not supposed to like constitute another government.
If you look back at any cultural movement that made an impact in the past 50 years, what did you have? The 60s revolution, where everybody was doing LSD, free love, love the one you're with, all that shit. You know, you had hippies running around naked, going to Woodstock.
Well,
look at Martin Luther King Jr. What did he was a leader, not an owner, not a fucking dictator.
Yeah.
It was about love. And there was a message, but there was also something emotional behind it. So libertarians are very logical and rational people. So, okay, fine. We can be right about shit. But we also have to work on being good people.
Yeah.
We also have to work on figuring out how to get along with each other.
Yeah. Agree.
That is a major thing that we are lacking right now.
Yeah.
Major.
I mean, I just feel like it's all on this power play, though. It all comes back to that. Like, if we stop, like, making things boards, because that's how you're building a system.
Let's create a government to protect ourselves from the government.
And that's
they
the
even
exact
have
thing
vetoes
we're trying to get
and
out.
Votes and Oh my God.
Yeah. It's like commerce and that fucking shit.
A fucking board.
And here's something that I find interesting. It's the people who they are backing. It used to be so different, and I've been in this movement longer than any of you have now. So like,
I mean, I feel like there are backers.
OG at the table.
I'm kind of jaded.
Which is crazy to say.
I know. I'm so young. Anyways, so back in the day, brief history lesson. I'll keep it nice and general. Martin Luther King ended up getting his activism eventually funded by the U.S. government. There's a reason that Martin Luther King's actions went over a lot better than Malcolm X, because Malcolm X was more about revolution. So they made him out to be a fucking brutalist dickhole, blah, 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 while Martin Luther King is like this fucking martyr. And I mean, they both had like the same goal, but, you know, had different directions of going about it. Once upon a time, and this, I guess this will kind of be an analogy, we in the FSP community were more about revolution, more about a levolution, but like we didn't care how we looked. Now it's all fucking political. Tables turned,
well,
man.
The dirty hippies need to take it back over.
I'm working on it, man.
Individual.
Liberty Shaman
Everyone
is here
needs
now.
To go full Keen.
Liberty Shaman is here.
Bring back the heyday of Keen, by the way, too.
Yes.
I'm ready.
Are you getting squeezed?
Wait.
Yeah, it made sense.
Okay, good.
No, that was good.
That was good.
That was good. Having a tough time paying your family's credit card. I like that segment. Maybe you were downsized or even
lost a job, but you still owe. It's a pretty good show so far.
Oh,
in general.
Yeah. I've enjoyed it. The first segment always sucks, though. I don't care what show I'm
really?
On.
Really? No. I feel like the first segment's always strong. That's how I feel. Like, you know.
I feel like it. Like,
more energy.
I usually enjoy most of every episode I've done. The second hour. I almost enjoy the second hour better every single time.
I always feel burnt out by the end. But we're on a good topic right now, so this is good.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
The fuck is the lighter?
Do you need a lighter?
Jesus, how many cigarettes have you smoked in the last 5 seconds?
It's the least I can do. 800-981-7590.
Get your shit together. Get out of debt now. I'm going to have to fight you.
Can I have one of your cigarettes? Thank you. Looking for an excuse to come check out
New Hampshire's Liberty Activism. Wow.
But I
they're sending 18 elephants over from Switzerland right now. How fucked up
I
is that?
I do want to. What?
Like they're packing 18 elephants into a plane to take them to an American zoo. Have fun at social events like the Halloween costume dance party. So they can have elephants at their zoo. Like, I don't know how many will die on the way there.
The first elephant that was ever in America stepped foot in Salem, Massachusetts. And the first thing it did when it hit the ground was throw up. Tickets are available now. This was in like the 1700s.
I read a book about elephants.
Interesting.
Do you guys know Jason Booth on Facebook?
Yeah.
Shout out to that guy.
He likes all my stuff.
He, on his A Wolf and Sheeple World page, he shared
That's
us again.
Him?
That's him. Same guy. I put that two and two together. He let it slip because he said I called him out on radio. I didn't call that out. I got you. I got you, Jason. In early trading Tuesday. Yeah, you messed up for a second. Don't do it again. But thank you for the shares. I'm loving it.
He must be so happy to have all four of us together
right
now.
I know,
right?
He loves one of our shares.
He's got to be.
Skype in, dude. If you're listening, if you're watching right now, Skype in, man.
I'm amazed. I'm amazed nobody's called in about this topic.
I know. Like, this
really?
Is a great topic to call
really?
Someone call in and fight with me. Visit us online at rrbi.co. Do it. Pussy. The three most important things you can
do for LRN.FM. They're just calling you out for chain smoking, that's all.
But I do want to bring it back to my love analogy for a second, too. I want to bring it back to that.
Okay, you bring it back, babe. Bring it back. Bring it back. Make that pussy come. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at
the
same
great prices, and LRN gets a cut. Please
eat it up.
I'll have a good pussy.
Oh my god.
Uber for years on the radio with their ongoing legal cases across the globe defending your right to give people rides.
Oh man, I never even asked you my relationship question. Maybe I'll ask you.
So I signed up to be a driver.
It'll be a good thing to close out
people
on.
And help Uber push forward innovation. As of this recording, Uber is active in 67 countries. So there's a good chance they're available in your area.
I'm so good at being mad, though. I'm so good at it.
You two are great at being mad.
Ah, I love it. I've said it before and I'll say it again. I feel the most fucking alive when I'm yelling at shit.
Oh, that's cute, Rob. Yeah, what? wouldn't want to call attention to the fact that
I read it already.
Fuck off. What contract, asshole?
He's full of shit.
Get over yourself.
Like, I feel like with that whole situation with me.
And if you just want to try Uber as a rider, visit ride.freetalklive.com. Your first ride's free.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
P.S.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. And, we're talking about the whole controversy going on in Free State Project and the latest drama, I guess. We kind of need to talk about it. Was Kyle Tasker being arrested? But that's not really the big issue. The big issue is, well, with all these porcupines coming out of the woodwork for and against violence for a victimless crime.
And also just deleting each other.
The ostracism and the lines have been drawn.
Yeah.
It's one thing if you were involved in the situation. But for you to delete people from Facebook and take them out of your social circle based on their opinion on one thing is overboard.
Yeah.
Or even better.
Overboard.
When you're no better than the government, fucking Liam and Al, because you're like, oh, Free Talk Live and Free Keen hasn't brought in any new movers over the past.
That's what I mean by no research. Like, they're just saying ignorant ass shit and they know nothing.
I want to say two things first, and we're going to go to a Skype call here in a second. First off, the whole thing with the Levolution thing that I was talking about beforehand, like, you see all these libertarians, like, drawing lines in the sand, like, I will like, do harm to one of my brethren that are porcupines if they believe in X, Y, and Z and blah, 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 and, like, creating, entire rifts in the community and shit like that over something like a disagreement on something, all right?
Over who's filming at a Freedom Festival.
It's fucking horrible. Yeah. The Garrett Ian
right
thing.
After the, right after that, Carla Grecki speech about always be filming.
Yes.
Like, literally right before.
Da irony,
so,
though.
And all that shit. And, you know, I came with this with the whole Levolution thing. Like, I understand that, like, you know, fuck the state. You know, I want freedom today, right here, right now. But that being said, what the fuck are you laughing at?
I'm sorry. Someone in the chat said, still waiting for Cody to self-immolate. And then I look over to poke Cody and show him, and he's still looking up the definition.
I was looking up the word. I'm not going to lie.
Okay. Can we bring on the RN studio?
Jesus Christ, kids. Jesus on a cracker. Okay. So, but anyways, the whole Levolution thing, the fact that, you know, I came in here like, you know, yeah, we're right on a lot of things. I get that. Freedom, blah, blah, blah. But at the same time, we're very logical people. But we need to, like, love each other. We need to, like, love, like, our brothers. Like, so live and let live. Not, you know, live or, like, ostracize, you know. And it's fucking crazy to see that.
Yeah.
I know. It's intense to see that. And that's not – if I saw all these drama threads before – and I'm still fucking moved. But if I saw these drama threads, I'd have second thoughts.
Everyone's
it's still
going
worth
full
people
camp.
People do. People
it's
do.
Worth moving,
it's worth moving because that's not the –
The thing that was holding
me
back.
We're not collective. It's individual liberations. You got to free yourself.
The thing that was holding me back from moving the most, and trust me, I've been considering this for 3 years. The thing holding me back the most was the bullshit drama in these Facebook groups.
Yeah, I hear you.
Hands fucking down.
That being said, I get what you're saying. I agree, but still make the fucking move. And on top of that, the whole thing with fucking Free Keen and Free Talk Live and shit like that, everyone in this room is in here because of LRN, all right? And there's so many people that move here. Well, you wouldn't have met me had it not been for that.
I'm here because of Derek J's victimless crime
story.
Because I watched it live in action.
I heard about
that. Can we bring on our guests?
Yes, we have the LRN studio in guests. LRN studio. Who's that?
Hey, guys.
Hey, Ian.
Hey, good evening.
Thank God.
I'm glad you took it to the point of love, and I think there's some, you know, we can dig a little deeper here into these angry libertarians and where are they coming from. Well, it's clear these are people who maybe they're real logical and they figured out why government doesn't work, but what they haven't figured out, it seems, is how to allow others to be free. And if you truly love the ideas of freedom and you love people, then you should respect them and allow them to live their lives how they want. It doesn't mean that you have to like it, I guess, But I feel like that's one of the fundamental failings of some of these folks. And I think also if you dig in deep, you'll probably find that a lot of them think sex is bad. You know, they've probably been raised with this very kind of puritanical belief that sex is naughty or sex is bad or it's evil and it should be restricted and it should only happen under certain circumstances, like when you're married or whatever. So I think there's a lot of like underlying a brokenness here.
Yeah, there was some lady who commented that she doesn't think that someone should be able to consent until they're financially independent. So I'm like, so no one's gonna ever be able to consent, no sex ever, only
And I think part of it also is that these people have always felt like outcasts because they're libertarians. You know, they have these viewpoints that are so drastically different in a lot of ways than much of society. And this is a way they can feel like they're part of the masses. This is a way for them to feel like they fit in, finally. Yeah. They're in the in crowd, and it makes them feel validated.
Know, I'll be honest. It saddens me that the in crowd is the ones that are advocating the okay use of force and violence against someone who had not yet committed a crime.
I mean, I feel like even these statuses I was reading about Ian, like back when I first like met him, about him being like a pedophile and stuff like that. Like, I thought that was sick. I thought, like, well, you're calling this guy like a pedophile for like being with someone who's like obviously consenting and saying, hey, I'm a person here.
But nobody cares what I think.
She's not a child. Yeah. And she's mentally, mentally underdeveloped or something?
I just said it earlier. Mentally
incapable.
I love how
Taking the heat off pedophiles. Like, that's fucked up. Like,
I love how, like, you know, Ian and Renee, your critics of your relationship, they will fucking say that to this day, literally, and probably to drop a thread right now somewhere on Facebook.
Yeah, they have.
And it's like, you're literally standing there, you know, as an 18-year-old, you're, you know, and their minds are already, you know, there, if they're defending that, because that's what they're defending. And you're literally saying there, no, I wasn't a victim. I consented. I chose to be there. All that jazz. You're literally you know, it's as if you're standing right next to them, and they're still shouting it at the rooftops.
Yeah.
And
nobody once has said it to my face.
It's like, what the fuck is going on? Like, this person's literally is alive right here, telling you to your face that is not true. The person that you're saying is a victim, yet they continue on with this, and I don't understand why they do that.
Yeah, and they have these like really deep-seated beliefs, but I feel like it's just violence, and I feel like they're making victims, and you can't make someone a victim.
Let me tell you this. The only thing that I was quote-unquote victimized by was the critics of the relationship who would fucking harass me online because I was incapable of making my own decisions. Let me just clarify for all those assholes who are still out there like, oh, Renee, you were raped. You didn't know any better. You were manipulated and blah, 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 blah. Nope. Ian didn't rape me. Like I said, actually been violently raped, and nope, not what Ian did.
What
Ian
do they call it?
An allegedly consensual
relationship.
Yeah, seriously, allegedly like, don't fuck consensual. Yourself. I own my body, not the state, not my parents, not anybody. Nobody should have to go to my mother and ask if they can have sex with me. Like, fuck. I'm not property. I'm my own person. You gotta get a permission slip. I'm a human being, for Christ's sakes. Treat me like it. Like, no matter how old I am. Be the person you needed when you were younger. Be the person you need when you were younger.
I feel like if you're like calling Ian a pedophile is just like, there's a lot of reason not to like Ian.
I wasn't a child.
There's a lot of reasons not to like him. There's a lot of like low blows you can throw. But I feel like pedophile is not in it. Yeah, that's nothing. If anything, I think Ian was the victim of Renee, and we should really evaluate that.
Honestly, probably.
We're all on Facebook threads about you being the victim, Ian.
I know.
You won't find that online.
You were taking advantage of
what Renee does, because I fooled around with my neighbor when I was like 11 years old. And I realize that's really young and everything, but I don't feel like I was a victim. And I've been told on multiple occasions I need to go and get therapy and that, you know, I've been harmed by this person. And I'm sorry, I had fun with him. So it wasn't a victimization at all.
That's beautiful, man. Rich Paul was the same way. And my first time having sex, I was 14. And you know what?
You lucky people having sex so young.
I wish I had. Like, have you ever heard the joke, which I say on every show? The mom asked the daughter, She said she goes to second base. She said, what's second base? French kissing? The doctor says, no, mom is anal.
Wow.
Like, that's today's society.
But seriously, I wish I had gotten laid young.
Yeah. Everyone's getting laid young.
I'm glad I didn't knock somebody up or whatever.
I was like 20 when I lost my virginity.
Oh,
I wish it was better than that.
What a loser.
I was 22.
Just like Ian. Two losers. I'm just kidding.
Wow. See, now there's two people who you can't look at either of us.
Wait, how'd you lose it at 10 and 20, or 11 and 22? What the fuck, Ian?
You had to get the last word in before the bumper. You just had to do it.
Yeah, it did.
He said fooled around. He didn't say fuck.
Yeah.
Oral sex.
Fair enough. I've never asked about the details. I don't care.
Why should you?
Exactly. Yeah. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
How could I not?
The other thing that is going on here, if you want to keep talking during the break, is the, I think kind of Renee touched on it, go full keen. I think that to some extent that's about being true to yourself, no matter what the masses are thinking.
I feel like everyone should just mind their own goddamn business.
I feel like I'm becoming like just as distant from the Free State Project as I did from the United States of America.
Oh my God.
Like
I don't mind dropping off the earth.
That boat.
Yeah.
Like, groupthink.
It's fascinating to see the the move's been triggered and people are coming, but there's a rift between, like, I hate to say it, the people that think more like free keen route and the, you know, and the people that are, will defend to the core FSP Inc. And there's like a there's
always
a
rift been there. Yeah.
I'm always, and I used to be the person who always wanted to volunteer too. Like, I used to volunteer like all the time for these events, even the comedy improv show. Like, I volunteered like for that. And now I'm like, you know, I don't even feel like I want to offer my services like to these events anymore because I just feel like I don't have the same views. Like, I kind of just want to do my own thing, do my show, and promote liberty that way, like individual liberation. And, like, yeah, move here. I want everyone to move here.
As long as it means, like, you know, if you want to say fuck the organization, cool. But for the people who are just, like, writing off entire groups of people within in the movement over one issue is fucking retarded.
Yeah, that's
we
bigger,
need to be able to work through stuff. And it's so easy. The problem is it's the online thing. It's so easy to write somebody off online because you had an argument and you got mad and you're like, delete them.
Yeah.
It's fucking stupid.
I'm not saying fuck
the organization. We need to be able to see each other in person and be like, we can get fucking past this.
Yeah. I'm not saying fuck the organization. I'm just saying, like, you know, I'm not going to volunteer as much and do as much as I used to. Because at that point, I feel like I really want to promote, you know, people being individually free than trying to, like, say, let's all group think. Like, I want people to move here and I'll come to, like, new movers parties. But I'm not going to, like, contribute to, like, any of these major events.
No,
besides my show,
I'll do my show. I stopped trying to do FSP related like promotions. I love the FSP and I love living here, and everyone should fucking move here.
The move's been triggered. Now we need to focus on trying, like you said, the move's been triggered. We need to focus on loving each other now.
FSP Inc. accomplished their mission. The move has been triggered.
We need to focus on being better people.
We need spirituality.
Yeah,
that's what it comes down to.
You put that out there. You put yourself out there as a spiritual person, as a loving person, as an accepting person, and you'll attract the right people to you. Yeah, the assholes will be here, but that's okay. We've got thousands more coming. You can only know so many of them. So just attract the right people.
Yeah.
That's why I'm not so much down with the FSP, because, like, what are we attracting now? Who's we?
Well, I just posted a Keenvention update, and it has yet to be approved on the FSP group. Normally, they approve my stuff pretty quickly, but in the last couple of days.
So, do you think it's true that you don't bring any movers, Ian?
Such bullshit. I've literally heard people say
I think that guy's
stupid.
Yeah. Dude, Liam Neal's full of shit. Fuck him.
And that's another thing. Based on Ian's opinion on Kyle Trasker, the FSP should cut ties with Free Talk Live.
Ungrateful fucking pricks.
Yeah, I feel like that's really,
really
dumb.
After all they've done?
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Oh, it's... I want to bring it back.
All right.
Down. Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. This is the Rebel Mistress. This is our final segment, and it has nothing to do with anything we were just talking about. So, Ian, you're welcome to stay or go. You know how it is, how it flows. You can stay. I have a question. Okay, so you guys were talking about Tinder earlier, and I wanted to know, there's this new like contour fad, like, and it's a video of this like going around. And it's of these girls who kind of, they look like trolls beforehand, and then they do all this makeup and contour and, like, everything, and they look, like, completely beautiful. Like, I mean, like, new women type beautiful. So if you meet a girl on Tinder and you take her home and she's, like, super hot, she's super beautiful, you're having sex with her, and her face starts melting, and then you realize she looks like a troll, like, do you guys have a problem with that, or are you pro, like, girl should contour, or is it false advertising?
False advertising. I'd be so fucking pissed. Oh, my God.
Have you seen the video?
No, I haven't.
Oh, my God. This girl, her face looks like a moon crater.
It's crazy what they can do now. I've seen a video of this girl who has enough makeup, so she's looked like five different black celebrities.
Wait, it was a white girl?
I can't remember what color she was, but
yeah, it doesn't matter.
Knows? Who knows?
But it doesn't even matter at this point. It doesn't matter. She could have been white.
Like, and my thing is, I'm all for plastic surgery and everything. Like, I totally agree with it. Like, tummy tugs, liposuction, facelifts. I'll do Botox. I don't even care.
I'm in favor of human beings being able to augment their body in any way, shape, or form that they choose is appropriate for them.
I agree, but the makeup
thing? That's outside the norm. If they want to have scales on their body or shit like that, or implants of, like,
I feel like you would take it to the point of, like, becoming robots, right? Right?
You just want to fuck a robot?
What?
No, because I feel, Rob, you're the type of guy, you're all into this technology, right? And you think the end game is living forever.
Yeah, which is stupid. Why is that stupid?
The point of living is to prepare yourself for the afterlife. Okay. Why would you want to extend life forever till you get bored?
No, life wouldn't be the same. Because once we reach the point where we could live forever, we'd evolve. That's the point.
We can ascend.
Yeah,
Cody.
We'd ascend.
What if you ascend after death? You don't know what the fuck happens.
Why do we have to sit here and fucking play God with our technology? When you die, you will be food for worms.
When are you going to report on it?
You're not going anywhere but into the dirt.
You don't fucking know that.
Technology will be the way that society
Have you done 5 grams of mushrooms? You don't know what the fuck
yes,
this is
I
about.
Have. I've done oh 5 grams, and I know that there is something more than our puny existences.
Ian, are you pro singularity or against it?
I'm kind of uncertain these days. I mean, I definitely know where Cody's coming from. Like, I don't have the desire to live forever like I once did. So I'm probably leaning a little bit.
So when do you
want to
die?
What's that?
When do you want to die?
I don't have any preference. I mean, I wouldn't mind living longer, you know, than the average.
How do you
want to
go out,
today.
Ian? How do you want to go out?
In a fiery blaze, right?
Hopefully as peacefully as possible. Dying in your sleep, I think, is probably the best way to go. But apparently I might get my dick chopped off.
I don't think we'll die from that. They could sew that.
I want to die after a night of doing blow off a hooker's asshole.
Ian, if
that sounds like a good way to go out, actually.
If we ever get back together, Ian, I will let you know.
You guys are never getting back together.
Don't even say that.
If things start getting bad in the long run, don't worry, I'll put you down.
If I knew you were going, I would have stopped.
I'm sure you put a lot of people down, so I believe you.
At this point,
I think we should all call Mark Edge to take us all out, like fucking Lassie.
I'll put you down, you dying dog.
You're welcome.
Hey, yeah. Ann, I heard you and Steven, I think, talking on Flaming Freedom about whether there was going to be some sort of gay dance party at Porcfest, and I was really committing to it, but I was surprised you didn't mention Keenvention and Halloween.
I did!
You did? Okay, I must have missed that part.
See, you self-promoting
dude.
You don't know shit,
Ian.
You
See,
don't know
here
shit.
Here we go with the self-promoting.
Okay, because
good choice,
I,
by the way.
Yeah, because I make sure I mention Halloween.
I'm sorry.
On
I apologize.
Many
I didn't hear that part, I guess.
I say
but,
it's going to be the shit.
But yeah, I think that's sort of going to be the successor to
the bigger dance party.
To the bigger
you
dance
definitely
party.
Should not fund the, like anything at Porcfest. If yeah, they're trying to ostracize you.
Oh, hey, one thing
after
you guys...
they fucked me, there was the year that Porcfest put the Mike and Vanessa Vine in charge, and they basically tried to screw me and Mandrick and Jay and Mark Warden over. And
their
try to make room
funders.
For a bunch of new blood sponsors, and they kind of tried to screw us, and it was really crappy.
So are you going to fund anything this year? I think you should boycott them, honestly.
Well, no, I like going to Porcfest, and I'll still go and set up the studio and do all that work, unless they kick me out, in which case then there's going to be no LRN studio. So
that would be a disservice to Porcfest if LRN didn't broadcast from Porcfest. Like that...
If LRN doesn't broadcast from Porcfest, I'm not going.
FSP, you know, OG Inc. people don't get, like... thousands of people can listen to like what's going on at Porcfest. It's documenting like the life and journey of what's life.
Don't they
like
understand when you control the media? They're fucking up. They're saying fuck you, media. Like, go away.
Every show,
like,
including Free Talk Live, especially Free
We're
Talk
doing
Live.
This shit every
Somebody
week.
Else
Free
start
Talk
on
Live
Liberty
broadcasting
Radio Station,
to 150
please.
Plus stations every night from this like Liberty Mecca and talking about what life is like there. And they
yeah.
think that's a bad idea to have it there.
Yeah.
Like, fuck that. Like, the fuck would they do that?
I meet people at Liberty Farm and Porcfest who are all listening to this show or listening to Free Talk Live or listening to RN. Oh, that's why I moved here. I love that shit. And now you're trying to ostracize that person. Like, you're making mistakes.
Found
Please,
out about
New
it
blood.
From Free Talk Live.
Yeah.
Or
yeah.
From LRN.
They're making mistakes, and I feel like that's how the government does it. Like, if you're going to be a government, at least be efficient. Like.
Please, New Blood. Come on. Somebody step up and do all the fucking work Ian does for LRN and bring that to Porkfest so you can kick Ian out. Please. I
no,
beg you.
There will be no media presence.
There's been talk about this for years, though. It's nothing new. Years ago, Mark called the board, the Free State Project board, a bunch of fucking idiots or something like that on one of our after shows. And, you know, there was a dust up about that. And then there was something else that I did at some point to offend Carla. And, you know, there's been a variety of these things. It's just sort of coming to more of a head now, I guess.
Yeah, now that the move is triggered, they're trying to make sure their political organization is not taken down by your Could pedophile be. Ways.
How yeah. long do you guys Psycho. Think the FSP should still exist until it's dissolved?
I think it should dissolve immediately.
Yeah, I'm kind of done with them.
Cody?
I don't give a fuck, man.
What about you, Ian? Do you think the FSP should dissolve, or how long do you think it should last?
Ultimately, I don't care because we have Shire Society. And the Shire Society can accept New Hampshire natives as well. So anybody who cares about freedom
that's
should
a great,
move here.
That's a great answer.
And that was a good answer. But I feel like as long as people move here, that's all I care about. Yeah, more like we should
get
20,000
people. I would
people
like
here.
To see, now that it's done, I would like to see more spontaneous order. You know, none of this, these people in charge or what the fuck is that?
Yeah, ostracizing
let's
people
actually,
from Facebook groups.
Let's actually be anarchist about this.
Yeah.
Socially, I mean, like only, socially anarchist.
Yeah.
You know,
the only thing
no leaders, no presidents, just we all just as humans fucking do whatever we do
yeah,
and whatever happens, happens.
Have a community. You don't need
spontaneous yeah. order.
You don't need leaders for that. Like community markets would still happen. Like these meetups
Agora.
Would still happen. Like everything would
Invention.
Still happen. Keep
People
invented.
Will still organize shit. People
yeah.
organize shit.
People will still organize
But you don't need leaders and presidents.
Yeah. When shit
that shit's over with.
And once you try to like turn your free system into a government, like you destroy your purpose. So I'm just gonna keep promoting, you know, move to New Hampshire,
move, yeah,
we're free, and liberate yourselves, like, and you know, just agree to disagree or disassociate. Just stop being dicks. Like everyone needs to calm the fuck down.
They need to look
seriously.
Yeah, that,
as like, much as much weed as we're smoking around here, you'd think we would calm down, but nobody is.
So it'll be interesting. How boycotted KeenVention is this year. It's like the most boycotted event of all the New Hampshire Liberty yeah. events.
I feel like still you have more supporters than haters. So.
Yeah. I wouldn't worry about it. I mean, like, especially, I don't know, my final thought in the whole Liberty movement is just need to calm down, smoke a little bit
Seriously.
More weed.
Yeah, take it
Start
easy.
Start loving each other. Like, we're all on the same team. We're all
hey,
on the fucking
team. I don't hold a grudge,
team.
Man, and that's, you know... If they want to be angry, it's just
oh no,
it's,
I hear you. You
too bad
you've
for them.
Right, and that's
good,
and that's so smart because you know what, when you have a bunch of people that you hate, that's hanging out in your consciousness.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's hanging out with you.
Yeah.
That's negatively affecting
yeah.
you more
that's
than
what
it is them.
Is about. It's about setting yourself free.
Jesus talked about this shit, man.
Who the fuck is that guy?
There
anyway,
goes being the prophet.
the shaman.
Peace be upon
Peace be upon you.
But I'm not fucking kidding when I say we need more spirituality in this shit.
And
I'm not fucking kidding.
And can you tell everyone where they can find you? Because I know you think you're important.
Where
but
can we find you?
No one cares.
Freekeen.com, freetalklive.com, keenvention.info. Now we've announced our hotel for Keenvention this year. It's the same one as last year.
Perfect.
Beautiful.
You can find Cody and I on Anarchy After Dark. And Cody, where else can they find you?
Offtheairalive.com.
And you can find us at rebelloveshow.com. Go like us on Facebook.
And go like the Rebel Mistress on Facebook.
All right. Peace, guys.
Peace.
See ya.
Thanks for being on, Ian. That was awesome.
That was fun. Thanks, guys.
Worth changing your life for. Bye, dude.
Peace.
See ya.